Jesus Christ was not even behaving like this. Okay, if Jesus Christ was telling you, be the first person in the flock
that you want people.
Oh, even Jesus Christ.
All we ask is for a little bit of behavior, you know, it's not.
Yes, it's human intelligence, your intelligent boy. That's why you need
to just relax.
Every one of you, you say, my body, okay? Well, where are you inside the body? Come on, point. Are you in here? Are you in here? Suppose you say, I'm in here, okay? Suppose we open up your head and pull out that brain. Is that you? Put it on the table. Is that you on the table? Is it? Suppose you say, I'm in here. And we take out your heart and, or your chest and put it on the table. Is that you on the table?
Chapter 14, verse 6 says the Son of God came to take away the sins of the world. There is no other way apart from the name of Jesus. I want you to know that Hare Krishna is not the way. Jesus is the way. Jesus died on the cross that you and me may be saved. There is no other way. And I thank the Lord for destroying the powers of the devil. Hare Krishna will not prosper in Uganda. Somebody prosper in America. This is not America. This is Uganda. This is not India. This is Uganda. We are born again. We are blood washed, anointed of God. Separated for God, set apart for God, the anointed of God, in the name of Jesus.
But the thing is, because people don't have a very broad mind, they have a very narrow mind, they think that my religion is the best, and that other person, I should kill him. Isn't it? I should kill him because he's not like me. Just like many people have come to your country, and because you don't look like them, they killed you. This is called sectarianism. It's called prejudice. It's called something which is very narrow-minded. Because actually all of us are sons of God. We are all sons of God, whether we're African or Chinese or English or Irish, whether we're Christian, Muslim, Jews, we are all sons of God. Just
our gospel is your philosophy. Our gospel is the revelation of the Son of God, who left heaven to die for my sin and for your sin. There is no other way under which you can attain your salvation. I rebuke that spirit of darkness upon your life, and I command to leave you, and I command you to get saved in Jesus' name, the Son of
God.
So the difference between the spiritual world and the material is that one is limited and one is unlimited.
And Jesus is the only link.
So therefore, those people who think that God is only with them, they are very, very limited. Because God is available to everyone. You think that God is so limited? You think that God is so limited that He's not available to everyone? He is available to everyone. He's not some small amount of people. You see? Just like I'll give you an example. If you have money, money is available in every country, not just in Africa, isn't it? Suppose I come to your country and I say, oh, we only have money in England. In other countries, they don't have money. That's a stupid thing to say, isn't it? Similarly, if you say God is only available in your religion and not in others, that is a stupid thing to say. And there are millions of dead people in coffins because of that statement. Yes, because of that statement, because of that narrow attitude, millions of people have been killed in the history of the world because someone is thinking, my country is the best, therefore let me go and kill this other country. Or I am better than you, therefore let me subject you. Or my religion is the best and yours is the not so good. This is just called, it's called what we call religious arrogance.
America, America, America. Armenia, take me to Harakrishna. I will not die. I will prosper. I will preach the salvation of God. I will preach Jesus. I will preach the revelation of Jesus. I am born again, spirit-filled, devil-chasing. I cast out devils. I pray for the sick and they get healed. I am an evangelist of God. I am an apostle of God. Anointed. I preach Jesus only.
And everyone watching that video, we bow and we Jesus. We command it to respect Jesus.
Hallelujah, the blood of Jesus breaks up a stronghold. It's the only way to heaven. Hallelujah, it's the only way. Jesus!
You are dependent. Everyone in this world is born into dependency. But God is independent. He is 100% independent. And if He wants, He can send 100 billion representatives. It's His choice. You cannot tell God what to do, what not to do. So we believe that all animals are also part of God. And they have a right to life. So we don't take any meat. We don't slaughter animals. We don't cut the throats of innocent cows. Because also in our friends' teachings, they also say, thou shalt not kill. Killing is actually evil. If you commit violence, violence will come after you. This is called the law of karma. You know that? Every action you do, you will get a reaction. As you sow, so you shall reap. Okay, so therefore, whatever you do in this world, just like many people think that I will go to church and worship God, but then afterwards I will eat the chicken.
Yes.
Yes!
So, let me say one thing. If you like to eat meat, why don't you go out in the jungle and eat the lions? They're also very tasty. The reason you don't eat the lions is because they may eat you. So therefore, this is called violence. You are committing violence upon someone who can't defend himself. Therefore, this is called bullying. You are a bully.
What you call uneducated statements. Uneducated statements. If someone reads our books, we would be happy to discuss with them who is Krishna, whether he's alive or dead. Just like if you go out to the desert and you meet someone who's in the desert all his life, and he comes up to you and he says, oh, your mother is dead. How does he know what he doesn't even know your mother? So the point is, it's not a question, it's not even an intelligent question to ask, because Krishna is not dead. Krishna is not a material body. He is not made of matter. God, the word Krishna simply means all attractive. Allah means the Almighty. Jehovah means the All Powerful. Krishna means the All Attractive. The all attractiveness of God is the most important feature of God. If God is not attractive, then there's no meaning to God, because that means you will be attracted to something else, isn't it? Suppose you say that bananas are more attractive than God. That means a banana is greater than God. So if you don't know what God looks like, how will you know whether he's attractive or not? Isn't it? It's a fair comment, isn't it? Suppose I said to you, our wonderful Christian brethren, can you describe the face of God? What does he look like? Answer. And I will question you one thing. Don't tell me he looks like Jesus Christ, because Jesus Christ said, there is one greater than me, my Father. It's him whom you worship. It's him whom you worship. My Father is the one you worship. You tell me the face of your Father. What is the face of the Father of God? What does he look like?